One of the most trivial things that baffled scientists for decades is how particle physics all comes together. Protons have a positive one charge, neutrons have no charge, and electrons have a negative one charge. Why is that? Well, the answer to that and a lot more came when they discovered quarks.
Quarks are 6 of the 17 fundamental particles that make up the universe. They have fractional electrical charges and are also fermions, meaning they have a spin or an angular momentum of 1/2, as opposed to bosons, which have a spin of 1. They tend to stick together in groups, and certain reoccurring groups have certain names, such as the neutron and the proton. The quarks in the neutron and the proton, namely the up quark and the down quark, do not decay, whereas all the others decay into these two quarks. Inside the proton and neutron, you get 3 quarks, 2 up and 1 down for the proton, and 2 down and 1 up for the neutron. While the proton and neutron may have a size and a mass, quarks only have a mass. To get to the size of a proton or a neutron, we have to look at the quark's movement. They move nearly at the speed of light, but seem to constantly bounce off a boundary, which is actually spherical, and is exactly the size of a neutron or a proton. What is actually happening is the strongest of fundamental forces, known as the strong nuclear force, is forcing the quarks to be held in a spherical arrangement. The nuclear in the strong nuclear force comes from nucleus. The strong force also provides a charge to the quarks, which physicists call color. This isn't the same as what we would usually describe color, but rather a variant of charge in terms of another massless fundamental particle, the gluon, and its interaction with the quarks, in a similar fashion to photons in the electromagnetic spectrum. The color, on the other hand, can be compared to that of electricity, the only difference being, this time there are 3 variations of the color charge rather than just 2. The gluons are drawn like springs, because that is essentially how they work. They pull quarks that exit the nucleon and barely affect quarks already in it. If scientists want to, they can apply a lot of energy and knock a quark out of the nucleon and supersede the force applied by the gluon. What you expect at first is you'd get a loose quark, but this opposes what I said earlier, where quarks like to stick together in groups. So instead, what they do is use this equation to convert energy into a quark and an antiquark. This doesn't break the law of conservation of energy, as mass in a way is just a form of energy. Overall, the interaction of quarks and gluons is what the field of quantum chromodynamics comprises of. What is so interesting is this is often theoretical and hasn't been proven fully. Instead, it's just a model for what we do know and how it all links up. This means that there is still a whole universe of knowledge and possibilities to figure out. And when we do, we'll have resolved many unsolved mysteries.